Hey guys, welcome back to Lisa's Study Guides. Today we're going to be talking about the body paragraphs of our essay. So the really substantial stuff that we've finally gotten to. If you haven't watched my other videos that have prefaced this one, then playlist down below for ya. Link up above for ya. So we are covering 2016 FECA exam. We're using Sarah's essay, who's one of my tutors from Lisa's Study Guides. She's kindly lent us this essay for us to go through. So yeah, let's just get started and I'll show you a few things for you to look at and to understand and take away and action on yourself. I would recommend that you download the PDF that I have linked for you just in the description box below, because it's quite a lot of text and I didn't want to put it on screen because that can be quite heavy. I will put some of it on screen, but just so that you've got the bigger picture, it's there for you. So in this particular essay, I would say that we went with the bridge structure just because she doesn't compare in every single body paragraph. In fact, her first body paragraph is just to do with Wiley, but it's very similar to bridge in that you can see how later in the second body paragraph, there's a lot of comparison, and the same with the third body paragraph. There is a lot of comparison back to Article 1 and Article 2. So let me show you where these comparative points are. We'll come back to paragraph 1, but you can see that at the beginning of the second body paragraph, she's using, on the contrary, Ian Warwick reasons that in spite of sharing Councillor Wiley's concern, proposal will cause the destruction of the beauty of the town in which they inhabit and will thus be counterproductive in rendering Lawton appealing to the outside world. So in that first sentence, we've compared their contentions, but rather than just simply, you know, stating how they're different, what Sarah has done is used comparative words like on the contrary and in spite of. So immediately we're comparing Article 2 back to Article 1. And then she starts delving into Article 2 a little bit more in the next sentence. He employs reptilian with a rhetorical question as he asks, can't we be different? Can't we have a cultural focus? Ultimately giving his viewpoint, suggesting to the audience that Lawton would be better liked by the public if it were more diverse, exerting its own culture. As we move into the next sentence, you can see that we then start comparing back. Warwick then ridicules Wiley's idea of a spectacular piece of modern architecture as he lists several components that would be more beneficial to the society, such as an art gallery, an annual music festival, a literary week. This evidently implies to the people of Lawton that Wiley's idea has not been well thought out and thus will lack its desired effect in attracting tourists. So I really like the way that Sarah has approached this, purely because the type of comparison that's made here is not just so obvious. It's not just on the contrary and likewise and then just leaves it there. She actually really digs deep into like how Warwick ridicules Wiley's idea, particularly the part where she says, this evidently implies to the people of Lawton that Wiley's idea has not been well thought out. Rather than just saying Warwick ridicules Wiley's idea, give evidence and then move on, she returns back to what she said originally about ridiculing Wiley's idea and really supports her point by saying that it wasn't well thought out. So already I could say that within the first four sentences, she's compared directly back to Wiley in three of them. He further denounces Wiley's proposal is another way that she's contrasting back to Article 1. Then in the next sentence, you can see that there's still more comparison with Wiley, especially where she says here, thus appealing to the need of community to support a better alternative to that of Wiley's. This is a really easy grab for you to compare. Rather than just finishing with appealing to the need of the community to support another alternative, which you could also say, what Sarah has done is switched that out to say a better alternative to that of Wiley's. And that in itself makes a more tangible, direct comparison with Article 1 yet again. So you can see how here how just the smallest shifts in word choice can really empower your essay and help you satisfy certain criteria points that are expected of you. So again, I think with pretty much almost all of the sentences in this body paragraph, there is a constant going back and forth between Warwick and Wiley and the different ways in which Warwick undermines Wiley's proposal. Now, if you are looking at this and going, oh my gosh, this is amazing, like I wouldn't be able to find this many comparative points, please don't stress. I think Sarah, she's obviously done very well in English. That's why she's a tutor on our team. She's an exceptional girl. But you know, for you, you don't have to be comparing in every single sentence and you shouldn't feel like you have to. I think it's definitely something that takes a decent amount of time to get used to and for you to just practice. But if you can even find two things or even three things to compare, that is a really, really good start. And if you remember in my previous video where I discussed structures, remember that with the bridge, you could either make comparisons throughout the whole paragraph or you could just make some comparisons at the start and then just move into Article 2 on its own. That is okay too. Now let's look at her body paragraph 3. So we've got a starting of, in a similar fashion to Warwick, Gary Shaw depicts the error in Wiley's thinking. So this is really nice because it's short, but it compares all three of them and discusses how Shaw is similar to Warwick, but different to Wiley. I like the fact that this paragraph actually doesn't make as many comparison points as the one before. And that's really to show you guys how it's still okay for you to just have some pieces of comparison points. So you can see the next sentence, a sign is shown in front of the town of Lawton that reads, Lawton, home of the giant watermelon. And of course that's very individual and specific to Article 3. And I'm just gonna call it Article 3 just so that it's quite clear, even though it's a cartoon, right? What he attempts to portray in doing this is the fact that if Wiley were to be supported, it would be a grave mistake for the community in the respect that Lawton will no longer be known or appreciated for its multiple and unique facets. And this is a really good sentence for me to give you an alternate example. I think for this particular one, she has mentioned Wiley, but she hasn't made a specific comparative point. And maybe this is just because she's going to do so later. But something to consider, and as an alternative, what she could have also done is say, Lawton will no longer be being known or appreciated for it, and then take the positive connotation words that we mentioned earlier in our videos. So you could either do will no longer be known or appreciated for its beauty, as Warwick contends. So see here how you're making a link back to Article 2. Or you could even say Lawton will no longer be known or appreciated for its beautiful bakery, historic pub, or comfortable motel, which is ironically what Wiley has mentioned as one of the things that is important and essential to the town of Lawton. So just like I mentioned before, how sometimes you just need to twist your words and be very specific with your word choices, and that could make all the difference in terms of your comparison. Having said that though, what she's written is absolutely perfect and fine. These are just alternatives for you guys, just for you to think about. This point is also another really easy comparative grab. The cartoon takes Wiley's opinion piece quite literally. So, you know, that's so simple. Rather than just going, there is a giant watermelon there, and that's pretty much it, really think about, how has this cartoon come about? Why does it exist? It exists because of what Wiley has said. So if you can draw upon something that she said and showcase how that has been taken and been put into this article or even in Warwick's article, which is a response to Wiley, then that makes a really good comparison point as well. I really like her next sentence as well. Alternatively, this could also signify a place in which visitors, after having visited the giant watermelon, can purchase a kind of souvenir in the form of a watermelon itself. So I really like how she's mentioned alternatively. Now, this isn't to do so much with comparisons as it is to just do with interpretations. I think you and I, as I always say, will always read an article or a book very differently and we'll come out of it thinking very different things. But sometimes we could look at one thing and go, whoa, there's actually two ways of looking at this. And this is clearly what she's done. So she's made one statement and then she's gone alternatively, here is another interpretation. And I really like that because I think examiners love it when they can see you moving just beyond your own lens and see, you know, how other people might be able to perceive this particular cartoon. So to summarize this paragraph, she's gone, ultimately, Shaw's contention is similar to that of Warwick, as both serve to ridicule Wiley, as her concept of attracting people to Lawton doesn't take into account the fact that the town will be recognized for nothing more than its giant watermelon. So another great area of comparison from Sarah there. So now that all those comparison points are done, you've just got your body paragraph one, which is just all about Wiley. So I think, as I mentioned in the planning video, I like to plan the comparison points first and then plan out what is going to be written for just specifically to that article. This doesn't mean that in the essay you do your body paragraph one last, but I guess just the way that I've gone about showing you this video, that's just how we've done it, but you know, still do it like in order. With this one, I won't read every single sentence, but I think that what's cool is what Sarah has chosen to write about. There's so many techniques that are being used. There's an entire page worth of content there for you to analyze, but it's interesting to see which specific techniques she's decided to discuss and how she builds upon those techniques. So notice how, you know, she says things like, additionally, she further incorporates. I like that because I think there's this sense of linkage between the sentences and a development of the ideas, rather than just going, here's one sentence, move next language technique, next language technique, next language technique. It's just like a gunshot kind of approach. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it from me today. Again, please, if you find this type of advice helpful for you, let me know in the comments section below. Let me know what you're after and what you'd like to learn more about, or if you have any questions. I think, you know, I'm really here just to help you guys. So the more that you convey to me your thoughts and your opinions, the better my work can be. See you guys then. Bye.